Hello, Senator. My name is St. Peter, and you are at the gates of heaven. You presented us with a complicated situation. You see, we don't get many politicians up here, so the other saints and I were a bit confused about what to do with you. So here is our procedure. You will spend a day in hell, and then you'll spend a day in heaven. At the end of both days, you get to decide where you want to be.
I don't think that's necessary. Heaven sounds a lot more
difficult. I'm sorry, it's been our decision. You are required to spend a day in both heaven and hell before choosing.
Okay, fine. When do we start?
Now, the elevator to hell is right here. Now spent a day in both. Where do you prefer to remain?
I'm not gonna lie. Heaven seems kind of boring. I'm gonna have to go with
that. Very well then. All right, you can take the elevator on your own this time.
Oh man, this is gonna be great.
Senator, yesterday we were campaigning. Today, we won the election. We are here.
Because this is all an accident? I'm not supposed to be here, and I didn't want to be here to begin with.
Senator, everyone who is here because he wanted to be here. Each one made the choice, and they forever hold to that choice. One thing you must learn, Senator, is that all get what they ultimately want. They do not always like it.
That doesn't make any sense. I've never heard of anyone who talks about wanting to go to hell. And furthermore, I consider myself to be a fairly moral person.
Yes, most people do. What you have been wonderfully oblivious to, Senator, is that for years I have been teaching you to center your life on your desires.
Wait, so just because I value myself means I want to go to hell?
Hell is the place for people who want to engross themselves more and more into their own habits. Your habits, Senator, are what you care about more than anything. More than God.
How can that be? That thought has never crossed my mind.
And that is what makes my teaching so beautiful. That someone so smart as you, Senator, could not even detect the values I've been placing in you from the day you were born.
I don't understand. How could I not have known what I wanted?
You never knew, because you have never made the effort to truly understand your desires. In essence, you deceived yourself.
So what was I supposed to do then?
I much don't like answering that question. But I'll indulge you. You see, in the Christian body of followers and believers, as they often label themselves, it is easy for me to plant in them the temptations and many of the values I've succeeded in placing in you. However, there is one difference. The Christian life calls for the consistent introspection of one's spiritual well-being, what some call soul. They constantly re-examine their underlying desires and, due to the salvation through Christ, the Son of God, allow God to have their desires resonate with His. By that point, there's very little I can do. That, Senator, is the difference. And that is what you can do differently.
Don't you mean what I could have done differently? I've already made my choice. I'm dead.
Not exactly. You're dreaming, Senator. But you've been in a coma this entire time.
So I'm not really dead then?
No.
Wow. Wait, I don't get it.
Okay, where do I start? You're not dead. This isn't hell. St. Peter's not actually let dead people decide where they want to go. You're not Satan, and Satan does not have a British accent.
Honey, I'm so glad to see you awake. How are you feeling?
Fine. It's really great to see you guys.
I think she must be feeling pretty overwhelmed right now. I think we should give her some space.